Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be going over my favorite new features in Lumion 10. One of my favorite features in Lumion 10 is that you can now preview your renders within the render window. Instead of having to render everything out at a smaller scale, you can just click in the window and it will preview the final render for you. This is great because there are some of the effects in Lumion that don't show up until you do the render, so this is a more accurate way of getting an idea of what your render will look like without having to spend the time to render the whole scene. Lumion 10 also introduces fine detail trees. Now before this update, I really didn't think that Lumion needed a tree update. In 9.5, they'd come out with a bunch of new tree objects, but you can see now in the UI, there's nature, and then there's fine detail nature. And they're being pretty general about that, so give some hope that maybe there's some things in the future that they will add. So here I've input two trees. Both of these are sweet chestnut trees, so they're similar, and you can actually see just from this view that these trees look completely different despite being the same. I don't know much about trees themselves, but these trees just look very different. So the one on the left is the standard nature tree, and the one on the right is the fine detail tree. So if we zoom in here, you can just see the leaves on this one, and then if you come over here, here are the leaves on this one. You can see there's like a lot more texture in these leaves and in the bark and stuff like that. Now this isn't perfect. If you zoom in really close, at least in this preview, you can start to see some of the polys. There's some like warbling effects on this wood, but what I have noticed is that in the renders, it makes a huge difference. Now, I wouldn't recommend using fine detail trees for every tree that you put in your project, just for whatever is close to the scene, but I think this really adds an amount of realism to Lumion that is missing that I didn't even realize. The fine detail trees also seem more responsive, at least more realistically responsive to wind. So if I apply a wind effect here, and then render, you can see there's just less movement. It seems like more of the leaves individually are moving instead of in the old trees or the standard trees, all of the branches are sort of moving together. So it just gives a more realistic effect in your animations as well. I do really love the fine detail trees. I think they're great. The only thing is that currently there aren't a ton of options. There's about 1.25 pages of trees to pick from, and the plants have about half a page. So while the fine detail nature objects can add a lot to your models, there's just not a whole lot of variety just yet. There are now options in Lumion to customize specific objects. It doesn't work on all objects, but for instance, if I select this car here, it brings up a dialogue and I can actually change the color, which is really cool. Also, there's this slider for lights and it will turn the headlights on, and you can also toggle on and off the driver. Same thing with this bike here. I can change the color of the bike. I guess they copied this over. It has lights, but I don't see any lights on that bicycle. So, but like this grill here, I can't change the color of that. So it's sort of some things you can change the colors of and others you can't, but it's a step in the right direction. And I'm really excited for things like cars that we have that feature. In Lumion 10, when you start a new project, there are some new environments that you can use to jumpstart your project and get into it a little bit quicker. The old ones are plain, mountain range, and white, but now there is forest, tropical, and suburban. When placing nature objects in Lumion 10, you now have the option to paint placement. So if you select paint placement, you get this circle here, and you can choose any of the standard nature objects. This doesn't work for any of the fine detail or any of the other object categories currently. So if I choose stone, I can up the density down here, and then I can just use this sort of like a paintbrush. Change the density to go down a little bit. Just sort of mess with that to get stone. Unfortunately, currently there's not a way to change the size of this circle. It's sort of set. All you can do is change the density. In previous versions of Lumion, if you used a real sky, you could only view it in the render window. In Lumion 10, they now added the option under weather that you can toggle a real sky and select the real sky from the menu like you would in the render output. And you can also change the sun direction. You lose the ability to change the sun height because that's an option for real skies. And as always, there's a brightness option as well. There's now displacement maps for materials. So if you go to the material library and you see this D down in the bottom corner, that means that that particular material has a displacement map applied to it. You can't set your own displacement maps if you create a new material, and you can't add them to any of these other materials. So basically, if it has a displacement, then you can apply it. If not, then you can't do anything about it. So you can see there's some wood that has displacement. There's some brick that has displacement. Sort of have to look for it. There's some down here. And then there's some sand. I think that probably the coolest ones are the soil. There's sand and like a swampy sort of thing. And so for this, I've gone and I've actually put in a bunch of different sand just to show you guys what's going on. So from left to right, we have zero relief, and then this is 100% relief, and then we just go 25, 50, 75%. And then going down, the same thing, 0% displacement, 25%, 50, 75, 100% displacement. And you can see how relief and displacement really work together. With just displacement, you don't really see anything. With relief, like you did before, you still get some dynamic shapes, but I think the coupling them together really makes a big difference. So somewhere in here, I think, is what the default sand is set to. You can see how nice that looks. It just gives a little bit more three-dimensionality to the surface. And then this is what you would have before. It looks pretty flat. This is just relief. So from a distance, looks pretty good. But when you start to get up close, it doesn't look that great. But with the displacement, it actually looks a lot better than it used to. There's now an option to cut terrain. This is an old example of Lumion and sort of the method that you had to use if you're putting in a pool or a basement. So you can see here, the land is coming and we have our pool here. And if I just clip through this, you can see that what you had to do was basically drill a huge hole into the ground. And in here it ends up working out because you have this huge sort of concrete that you can mask this with. But if this was, you know, smaller, it can get really problematic of how do you fix that? How do you get the land to sort of mesh with that? So now if you go to objects and under utilities, you can now place this cut. It allows you to put this little square here, and then you can just change the size of it. There you go. Just sort of clips through the whole world. There's some other features in Lumion 10 that I felt like are worth mentioning, and I'm just gonna quickly go through those. I didn't think these qualified as the best, and I'll explain really briefly why, but one of the additions in photo and in video is now in real skies, there's an option or tab for night. These are pretty great if you're looking for night renders. I just think I wish there was more in there that weren't so starry. Being able to see the Milky Way and things, I feel like the use cases for those are pretty small, or just being able to see all of these stars just seems like too much. So I just wish that there was a little bit more options that were less dramatic. Along those lines, there's now an option to add an aurora borealis. I think this is really cool for adding a lot of drama to your photos. Again, I just feel like the use cases for this are pretty small. Maybe you could use it on one project, but I don't think it's something that you would use all the time. They've also added photo matching to the effects, so you can see if I double click on this. This is one of the example files that Lumion has. You can now match a photo. I just think this particular option is sort of defeats the purpose of making realistic renderings. It seems counterproductive to me to do composites. So I couldn't see myself using this. These look not that great in my opinion, because you're trying to merge these two mediums that don't really fit. The last thing that I wanted to mention, because it's kind of cool, but I just could never see myself using it, is that under Artistic 2, there are some AI artist styles. So you can pick some different artists and just sort of have a rendering come out in a style that's similar to theirs. So for this, just really quickly save this. So what it does here is that it renders the image as a normal render, and then it does some AI stuff. I don't know, there's a pretty cool graphic that ends up coming up. I don't know if that has anything to do with anything or if it's just a graphic that looks cool. And then it shows you the style. It's pretty cool. I just feel like, again, the use cases for this are pretty small. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Is there anything in Lumion 10 that you thought was going to be included that wasn't, or that you wish was included? Let me know in the comment section down below. If you thought this video was helpful, please don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe, and as always, happy hacking.